Should we be hopeless? Should we be pessimistic? Should we just give up and say, oh, the situation is so bad, we should just not do anything? Well, if we do that, then we will be forsaking the words of one of our national heroes, who said, to erect the true edifice of our social regeneration, we must radically change not only our institutions, but also our ways of being and thinking. We need an external and internal revolution at the same time. It has always been my belief that we cannot repair something until we know what is wrong with it. And so we cannot simply turn a blind eye to the problems facing the judiciary. Instead, we must confront them and confront them squarely. And that is the only time that we will be able to overcome them. It has been said that of our three branches of government, the judiciary is the last closed expression of democracy. I think it's high time for us to open that door and shine some light into that room so that we will see how we truly render justice in the country. But I'm sure many of you young people must be wondering, is this just sheer idealism? Is this something that is unattainable in my life? Why should I go after this? Is this just like the man of La Mancha chasing after windmills? Well, I will answer you again with another quote from my favorite source. If you mean meet completely and immediately, they are. But only yesterday in world time, it was thought impossible to land on the moon. And not too long ago, Aristotle, one of the wisest of men, justified slavery as natural and listed torture as a source of evidence. So standards thought too high today may well turn out to be too low tomorrow. But whether they do so or not is not really important. What Nikos Kantzakis said of freedom can be said of justice. The superior virtue is not to receive justice. It is to fight relentlessly for it, to struggle for justice in time, yet under the aspect of eternity. Thank you very much.